Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Blessings to everyone. So there is a lot of people that they say I'm awakened or I'm enlightened, and what does that mean? In our tradition, there is always a fixed number of what most people would call enlightened people. This number does not change when one is leaving his body, then another will take his place or her place, and this number stays. So, first of all, there is hundreds and thousands of awakened people. Awakening is a state that you reach to self through self-observation. And when you make a process of self-observation, this can happen by meditation, this can happen just to daily practicing, that you really learn to see yourself, the ego structure, and you understand your shadow self. You understand somehow that the ego is always in polarity and that you need somehow to coexist with this polarity, because you see this also reflected in reality. On our earth is not happening just peace. And you will not find a place in the world where that is just like this. If it is just like this, it is on the other extreme of the spectrum. That would be what is described as heaven, no? Or a paradise. And the other extreme of the spectrum would be described as hell. So in the middle, where there is the most, you find everything at the same time. So there is most of the civilizations, they move towards a heavenly situation, but then it means also they will not keep these bodies and they will not keep a lot of other things. But even so, they are still in interaction with other beings that they are maybe not so heavenly oriented. So they will come with their aggressions and they will come with their forces. And now on earth, we are in a state that we are still busy with our inner forces. That means at that time, we still fight each other. There will come a moment that we stop that, because we will have a greater enemy coming from the outside, for example. No? But this is just on the outside, on the surface like this. Now, awakening means that you learn to coexist with your inner conflicts, with your inner polarity. No? You are a person who wants to be true, but you will find a liar inside of you as well. And if you are not aware on that, then you will start to oppress this liar. And if you are too extreme in oppressing, those attributes manifest through people that you meet and they lie at you, for example. No? So when you judge something too much in others and you cannot see it in yourself, you will attract this kind of situations to you. Now, enlightenment is a totally different thing. And we call enlightenment the state of witnessing. So witnessing means that you are not anymore attached to what you see and what you feel. You feel and you see, but it is not yours. It is like you are a person, for example, a police person, and you witness a crime, no? or you witness an accident, someone's house has burned. Now, you can feel and understand the suffering of a person who's just lost his house, but it is not yours. You will look to it in a neutral way. While when you are still in the observing mode, you will become a part of this emotion. You will be emphatic in a way. And this empathy is a good thing because it makes us to be a human and it makes us to understand what the other ones go through. However, enlightenment is a different level. It is not any more divided. There is no division. This is a good thing. This is a bad thing. This kind of division doesn't exist. And enlightenment is not something you can achieve yourself. Awakening is something that you can achieve yourself. You awaken, for example, sometimes in a dream, right? And you can train that to awaken, to become aware that you are dreaming. But you cannot enlighten yourself. This is something which is given to a person for whatever reason. Only the divine knows it, why it is given to that person and just to that person. And when someone like this appears, a person like this can never be unnoticed. These people are touching the society in a very, very big amount. They have different powers, they run on different energies. They are completely out of their ego structure. What connects them still with certain ego artifacts, let's say, is their body. But in themselves, they are living and exist on another level. So it's not possible to really compare them. At every moment in this world, there are just five absolute enlightened ones. And most people will never meet them. Because what happens if you meet one of them? It is your life belongs to them. You cannot choose. You cannot relate to a person who is like this, just like you relate to your neighbor. You cannot say, oh, I like that person, you know, and I like to visit from time to time. No. When you meet a person like this, when you meet one of those five, you have to give your life to them. There is not an option. It will be just happening. And why, when you meet an awakened one, you can like him or like her and you can want to follow them if they are teachers. Not every one of them is a teacher. But they will not ask your life, first of all, because they cannot hold it. They understand. They are not yet ready to really hold you and to take responsibility for somebody's soul in a way. While an enlightened one is the way around. These people are God walking on earth. They take you as God takes you. They can do what God can do. There is not really a difference there. And being with a person like this is like living and facing the sun. When you face the sun, what happens is that you cannot really observe yourself in that moment because you are so absorbed in looking at that sun that it will not be possible to really see yourself. And this is the reason why you find these strong stories, you know, that people who accompanied the Buddha or accompanied Jesus or accompanied other great masters, that they had a lot of conflicts in their communities. And you ask yourself, why is it? And others, you find them very peaceful. and they seem like they work on each other and they are really developing, and it's basically very peaceful. With people who are enlightened, it's never peaceful. It's like the full spectrum of what we have also on Earth. They somehow shrink the human situation to a small place, and you find all kinds of happenings there. You know? It can come up to killing. It can come up to God knows what. All the spectrum you will find there. In so-called other places, spiritual places, where there is teachers and they know how to speak, they know how to explain things very nicely, this is not happening. Yeah. So you look, for example, to a Gurdjieff, yeah. And he had all kinds of disasters in his place. No? You look to Osho, yeah. And look what happened. One of the students wanted to kill hundreds of others. No? This will not appear in places where there is just people come together and they try to work on each other and they do certain things. Yeah. So witnessing being enlightened is something which is thrown on you. And when that is thrown on you, you will have a mission, you will have a divine position. And you will also understand who is with you, who on this earth has the same position like you. You will be in a kind of contact with them, but you will practically never meet physically. If you meet, this meeting can happen only very, very short, because otherwise there will be an imbalance created on this earth. And that's why we say in our tradition that there is these five poles, these five pillars, no? And these five pillars, they live as far as possible from each other. No? So not to come too close and create any kinds of imbalances. While the awakened ones, they can live, 10 of them at the same place. And what we need now in this time is actually more people to awaken, which means they can find somehow a certain peace in themselves, they can find somehow a certain vision about themselves and just live a good life. Live a life with dignity, live a life with a good purpose, be a servant and ready to obey, you know, to those who are over them. Yes. So meeting a son, meeting an enlightened one, which he says in the word, no, enlightened, he's a kind of son, she's a kind of son. This is not a meeting that you can just organize it in yourself and say, ah, yeah, he says this, he says that. Let's look what another one says. No. These people, they take your heart, yeah, fully. And they will tell you what you do, whom you marry, how you work, how you walk, how you eat, how you dress. Everything is just taken over. Yeah. And you follow them the way they arranged it for you. When I met my master, who was a son like this, who was one of those enlightened ones, my life turned 180 degrees. Everything I wanted to do, becoming a doctor, becoming a musician, these were my two ideas about my life. Both of these was totally cancelled. And what I was doing were finding some kinds of works, mostly it was labor work. And I was picking oranges, almonds, olives, and whatever there was to do. nothing of what I have thought. But I could carry it. I could accept it because there was the sun with me. There was every day. It was so intense and was such an incredible day. When you are with the sun like this, it fills out your mind. It fills out your heart. It is everything, absolutely everything. And it cannot be really shared with somebody who hasn't experienced that. It is not possible really to make others to understand what is going on inside a person who is with a sun like this. Now, most of them are very, very restricted in a way. They restrict themselves. They don't show themselves to the public. And it is because we don't need at this moment this kind of magnets. Yeah. But we need more a collective consciousness so that we can concentrate and focus on things we have to do. And the first thing we have to do collectively is to respect each other, to give everyone the right he has and he deserves, not going on religious differences too much, not propagating one path and say all the others are wrong. This is the only one. This is not going to help now. Yeah. You can love your own path with all the love you have, with all the devotion you have, with all the passion you have for. And out of passion, you can say sometimes things. No, you say, oh, we have the greatest whatever. No, that's all right. But it is somehow forbidden in this time to put other people down. It doesn't matter who they are. Yeah. Just because they say, I do not believe the way you believe, it does not give anyone the right to say, this is a bad person or this is not a good person. So we do not waste our time anymore in those very fruitless discussions. No? When a sun arrives, and it was like this with all the suns who arrived in the past, they can attract from any kind of religion, from any kind of nation, from any kind of background, they attract people and they just melt them together. That's their power. And they will never look down on anybody. There was a very famous Sufi master. His name was Abu Yazid al-Bistami. He was also known as Bayezid. And he had a servant who was a Zoroastrian, what they call a fire worshipper, no? And he was an absolute devoted servant to Bayezid. And the other Murids were always trying to somehow convert him into Islam. Of course, his sheikh was a Muslim. He was teaching inside the Islamic world. So it was a weird thing that his very close person, who was his servant and stayed practically 24 hours with him, was a Zoroastrian. So they asked him on several occasions, why do you refuse to take the path of your master and to accept his religious way and to be one of us? And he said, if to convert means that I have to become like Bayezid, I cannot do that. It will never be possible for me. And if it means to become like you, I don't want to do that. I don't want to be like you. So he was a very particular character, no? But in a way, that was his truth. So when someone finds his truth, going a straight path, doing all right, wanting to know himself, wanting to be a servant, you be very careful to criticize those people. And it's not about becoming a saint. Even saints, they say things to each other. Beside that, yeah, it is not that you have to agree with everyone. You can distinguish, but you have to respect everybody. You have to give your respect. So we don't insult people. We don't put them down. And I was taught that the most trouble you receive in life is because of disrespect, of judgment. We judge permanently this one, that one. And many people ask me to say things, for example, about the pandemic situation, and to take a position and to judge and so on and so on. But when something is as big as this, it has a lot of aspects. One of it surely is a divine aspect. So this business is too big for me to really understand it. And I haven't met anyone where I have the feeling they really understand it. There have been a lot of things which are not to my understanding. There have been things where I cannot even understand it. There's no logic to me. But I understand one thing. All what is happening now will bring something to the surface. This is what I see. It brings things in people to the surface. It shows, let's say, what we say, their true face, no? And it brings also institutions to their surface. So in time, we will understand what it is. And make your intention to follow the truth. Have this intention, say to existence, say to, if you believe in the divine, ask to be guided in truth, no matter what is your belief, no matter what is your mental condition. Ask for the truth, because this is where we meet. The truth is the unifier. Love is not the unifier, because love has to do a lot with taste, with aesthetics, and this and that. Not everyone sees beauty in the same way. Not everyone loves the same food, and so on and so on. But truth is the one unifier. And this is why everyone is born in truth. You do not have to explain to anybody what is truth. They feel it, they know it, and you know it when you are true or not. So follow the truth radically. Try that, have that intention, and ask to be guided always to truth. As long as you can allow that, it will come to you and it will save you. And for this reason, Jesus said, the truth will set you free. He didn't say the love will set you free. He didn't say forgiveness will set you free. All this is a part, but it starts with truth. You forget truth, you forget all. Truth is the golden key, which has been given in our hands from birth on. Use it. Use it wise. And you will lead a successful life, and we will become a successful humanity. This is my prayer, that everyone can live a life in truth, that we find the common intention for the truth, and this is where we will meet. Thank you very much. I wish you the best. Stay healthy as much as you can, and see you soon again. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Blessings to all of you.